Thanks, David, and hello, everyone. I'm super excited today to present a very quick demo that how you can create a calendar event using Power Automate. My name is Vipul. I am working as a Power Platform Solution Architect in Bosch in India. I'm from India. These are the quick links from where you can connect with me on LinkedIn, and this is my YouTube channel. And I'm super excited for this journey today and this demo today. So I'll talk about the scenario that what pulled me to create this kind of a small demo, which actually creates the ICS file, the calendar event file, based on some automation using Power Automate Flow. So the scenario is that the customer had already some meeting management and stuff like that, where they were leveraging, let's say, SharePoint event management, but they wanted to create a meeting. So the moment the meeting gets created, it gets created in a SharePoint environment, let's say a SharePoint list, for example. But the requirement was that whenever this meeting gets created, the recipients should get this event calendar directly into their inbox, and then they can add it to their calendar. So directly the meeting can be added to the user calendar. So this is the problem statement, and I will just talk about a little about ICS calendar file. I would like to just showcase some of the properties that what is ICS calendar file. So when we talk about ICS calendar file, this is some of the properties of this file, which talks about begin v calendar, which denotes this is a calendar file with version. This is a particular version which needs to be provided, which we can say as the file version. Broad ID, you can specify any static string value, your URL, your blog site, anything like that. Begin v event, which defines, actually, this is the start of the event. So you can see here on my screen, begin v event and end v event. So this is basically the main part which defines our ICS file in any calendar event invitation. UID is just a unique identifier. You can specify any unique identifier. DT stamp, the timestamp that calendar event when you are generating that calendar event. So that is also one of the important property, I will say. The other two most important property which actually defines any calendar event is the start date and time and end date and time of that event. So DT start and DT end are the two properties. I want to talk about this property. This is in a particular format. The date format must be ISO. So it should be ISO format, ISO 8601 format, which is YYYMMDD, THH, hour, minute, second, and Z. T here denotes the time, which comes after time, and Z is just for the UTC offset. So this particular DT start and DT end needs to be defined in this particular format only, which is actually known by this ICS file. Summary is just the title of the event. Description, you can specify what this event is all about. Location, maybe the location of the event, URL, and the end parameters. So when I say end parameters, these are actually defining the end of this ICS file. Now, in terms of implementation approach, as this is a Power Automate flow, just a snippet, then I will walk you through the original demo or walk you through the demo. But as an implementation approach, this is just a snippet that how it has been implemented. Intentionally, I'm doing it just for this demo purpose, manually triggering a flow so that I can show you the input parameters as well, where I'm taking the input parameters or the details from the user, let's say input in this particular flow. Then I'm initializing an ICS variable with all these properties which I showed just now. Then I'm creating file. Here you can see intentionally, again, I'm using the OneDrive action, but rest assured, and just to let you know, you can use SharePoint actions as well. So SharePoint standard actions can be used as well here for creating the file, getting the file content. So SharePoint actions are also possible. After getting the file contents, I'm sending this particular event or this ICS file as an attachment to the recipient. However, if you want to delete this file, you can again delete this file, which you have created just in this action. So this is about just this event creation. So now let's see this in action, that how I'm going to do this in Power Automate Flow. So I've just created this simple, clean, plain, simple Power Automate flow. So in the first step, I'm just manually triggering the flow. However, what you can do is if you have a Power Apps Power Automate combination, you can take the input parameters from Power Apps and then you can create an instant flow and as well an automated flow as well. So these are some of the input parameters which will be taking as an input when we will execute or run this flow. Some of the input parameters like a start date, I talked about end date, subject, location, description, URL, and email to send, which is the recipients of the email. So these are some of the input parameters which I'm taking while executing this flow. Then just for, again, the demo purpose, I'm just taking two another variables in Power Automate Flow, which is a start time, some random start time of a string time I'm just taking, just to demonstrate here. And then I'm taking one more variable for the end time. So you see here, this is a 24-hour format. This is a very important note here. This follows a 24-hour format. So this is basically 7:35 a.m. I want to schedule my meeting, and then it basically ends at 8 a.m. again, since this is 24-hour format. Now, this is the most important variable, which I have defined as ICS. You can name it anything you like. You can name it any variable name of type string. Now, these are the properties which has been defined here. The most important property I want to talk about, DT start and DT end. Since I have used some, let's say, expression here, for example, format date time, I want to format date time. Then I want to convert time zone in the UTC. As I said, the time zone should be in the UTC format. And then I'm concatenating some variables here. Let's say, for example, start time and T, because T is the time offset, and then Z is the UTC offset. So those kind of things I'm just pending using this expression for start, DT start, which is a start of the event, and DT end, which is end of the event. The other parameters, for example, summary, description, location, URL, all these has been taken as the input parameter from my trigger. Trigger in this case, just to let you know, is the manually trigger a flow. So this is the trigger from where I'm taking all the input parameters. Once this has been defined, the main variable has been defined, which is the ICS calendar variable. What I'm going to do is I'm creating a file. This I'm creating in OneDrive, because in this case, I'm using a OneDrive action. You can see here, I'm using the root path of OneDrive. You can use any path to create this invitation file, which is ICS file. You can name it. You can give it any random name. And then file content, you see here, this is the variable ICS, which I'm taking here as the file content to create the file. After that, I'm using the get file content action, again, a OneDrive action where I'm passing the ID from the output of my previous action, which is the create file action. And once this is done, I'm sending the email to the recipient. Now, the most important part here is I've defined the recipient, subject I'm taking from the input parameter, body, maybe you can take description or summary here, all those parameters you can take. And after that, what I'm doing is I'm also putting the attachment, because that's the whole purpose of this demo. So in this demo, what will happen when the user or the recipient will receive an email, they will have the ICS file as an attachment, which is the calendar event file, and they can add to their calendar. So that is how it is, this attachment. For the attachment particularly, you have to remember and pass two important properties, I will say, which is name and content bytes. For the name, I'm passing the name from the previous action output, and for content bytes, I'm passing the file content property. So that is how this send an email action has been set up in this Power Automate Flow. Last action, which I have used purposefully because I want to delete the ICS file also, which has been created. Once everything has been done, I just want to delete the file from my location, which is OneDrive. So that is how it has been implemented. What I'm going to do is I'm going to now test it. What I'm going to do is manually trigger this flow, because that is my trigger. Just for this demo purpose, to showcase you that how you can set up the properties, create the ICS file, and then it's done. So let's start date. Let's take the today's date, for example, which is 16th July. End date, again, I want to do this today's calendar event subject. Let's say community demo. I'm just passing community demo. Location, any location you can pass. I can pass as MS Teams online. And then description, calendar event. URL, I can pass the URL of my blog site, for example. I can pass any URL here, and then recipient, I can send the email to me so that I get an email, and then I run this flow. Once this flow has been executed, you can see this shows that the flow has ran successfully. You can see here your flow ran successfully. And if we talk about the parameters or the actions, all the actions are executed. And once I go to the Outlook, if I see this Outlook, my inbox, I can see definitely an email which I have received using this Power Automate Flow. You can see here, this is the email which I've received, the same email which I triggered from the Power Automate Flow. This has the subject, this has the content, you are invited. The subject, the title of this inbox mail is community demo. And you can see there is an attachment here, which is invitation.ics file. So this was the name of the file which I gave during my properties. I can see this, that this has been scheduled for the desired time where I wanted the event. Now, what I can do is, this is for 16th July, 7:35 a.m. What I can do is I can add it to calendar. Now, once it is added to calendar, it will show me that this has been added to calendar. And what you can do is you can go to, let's say, your calendar in your inbox, and you can see that for 7:35 a.m., this event has been scheduled. You can see community demo in this particular time range, which you specified in the property of your flow. So that's it in this demo. That is how, I mean, you can automate the creation of the calendar file using Power Automate.